Chairman and Managing Director, Indian Express Group, Shri Vivek Goenka. Executive Director, Indian Express Group, Shri Anant Goenka. Chief Editor, Indian Express, Shri Raj Kamal Jha. Recipients of the Ramnath Goenka Excellence in Journalism Awards for the year 2018. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. I feel happy to participate in the Ramnath Goenka Excellence in Journalism Awards function. I am told that these awards were started as part of the birth centenary celebrations of the late Goenka ji. These awards honor those journalists from print, broadcast, and digital media who have maintained the highest standards of their profession and, despite immense challenges, produced work that sustains public trust in the media and impacts the lives of people. In other words, the awards are meant to felicitate those who hold their pen for truth. I congratulate all the award winners and urge them to never let go of their pursuit for truth, which is the only compass for good journalism. When the group chairman, Sri Vivek Goenka, met me to extend the invitation for this program, on a lighter note, he reminded me of the fact that I share my first name with Ramnath Goenka ji. I said, yes, it is a pleasant coincidence in which I am sure you all would agree I have no role to play. Ladies and gentlemen, may I also add here that it is indeed an elevating experience for a humble Ramnath to participate in an event named after the redoubtable Ramnath, whose stories of fight against oppression and persistence for truth are stuff of legend. But what I do, and all of us must, share with Goenka ji is his passionate nationalism. I ardently share his dream of a strong and prosperous India. Fondly called RNG, he was a matchless media personality who influenced the country both before and after independence. He was a businessman who had the canny ability to build an empire of real estate and utilize his wealth for public service journalism. The hallmark of his endeavor was an uncompromising journalism of courage, a journalism without fear or favor, its fundamental commitment to truth above all else. When he suspended the publication of the paper during the Quit India movement, his editorial spoke of the heart strings and not the purse strings. Over the decades, the Indian Express Group has truly evolved itself into an institution which encompasses the best values and traditions of journalism. It has cultivated a culture of irreverence towards authority and sought to practice journalism by speaking truth to power. Goenka ji left behind a rich legacy in the able hands of his successors who seek to carry his message forward. As you all know, I was born and brought up in Kanpur, a city which once set the highest standards for journalism. Let us remember Ganesh Shankar Vidyarthi, an extraordinary journalist who sacrificed his life to douse the flames of hatred during communal violence in Kanpur. As a journalist, his written words were not only prescient, but also showed his deep concern for the marginalized sections of the society. Writing in the revolutionary newspaper Pratap, which he had founded, he drafted what should serve as the mission statement for every journalist. Here I would like to quote Vidyarthiji's own words. Kisi ki prasansa ya aprasansa, kisi ki prasannata ya aprasannata, kisi ki ghurki ya dhamki, hame apne sumarg se vichlit na kar sakegi. Satya aur nyaya hamare bhitari path pradarsak honge. Sampradayik aur vyaktigat jhagdon se pratap sada alag rehne ki koshish karega. Uska janm kisi vishesh sabha, sanstha, vyakti ya mat ke palan poshan, rakshan ya virodh ke liye nahi hua hai. Kintu uska mat swatantra vichar aur uska dharma satya hoga. Unhone aage bhi kaha, hum nyay mein raja aur praja dono ka saath denge. Lekin anyay mein dono mein se kisi ka bhi nahi. Hamari yeh hardik abhilasha hai ki desh ki vividh jatiyon, sampradayon aur varnon mein paraspar mel milap badhe. Unquote. The sagacity of Vidyarthiji's writings were never confined by the narrowness created by humans. That was his journalism. In pursuance of his dream of a strong and united India, he sacrificed his life for peace and non-violence like a true disciple of Mahatma Gandhi. Ladies and gentlemen, I know that I am recalling a period when mass communication was still in infancy. We were then far away from summarizing our messages in a few characters and spreading them faster than wildlife. Indeed, technology has drastically altered the nature of journalism. Old timers would recall magical touchstone of 5 W's. Whose answers were essential for a story to qualify as a news report. In the din of the breaking news syndrome that has consumed the media now, this fundamental principle of restraint and responsibility has been undermined substantially. Fake news has emerged a new menace, whose purveyors proclaim themselves as journalists and taint this noble profession. Technology has given rise to a new breed of journalism which stands in contrast to traditional journalism. This development has revived the old debates about the status of facts and opinions, about credibility and authenticity. What is desirable is objectivity, which allows journalists to be open to facts and present all sides of a picture. Fidelity to facts, digging for truth, and keeping one's lens clean and sharp is imperative. Ladies and gentlemen, I am aware that journalists tend to wear many hats in the line of their duty. These days, they often assume the role of an investigator, a prosecutor, and a judge. All rolled into one. It requires a great deal of inner strength and incredible passion for journalists to play so many roles at a time to arrive at truth. Their versatility is praiseworthy. But that prompts me to ask if such a sweeping exercise of power is accompanied by genuine accountability. Ponder for a moment as to what Goenka ji would have done had he encountered a crisis of credibility on account of paid news or fake news. He would never have allowed the situation to go adrift and initiated measures for course correction for the whole media fraternity. There is no doubt that journalism has been passing through a critical phase. The quest for truth is, of course, difficult and easier said than done. But it must be pursued. A democracy like ours deeply relies on the uncovering of facts and a willingness to debate them. Democracy is meaningful only when the citizen is well informed. In that sense, excellence in journalism grants full meaning to democracy. If journalism has to remain relevant, it has to retain its sense of mission. It has to reclaim its values of honesty and fairness. It has to, 24/7, reinforce its compact with citizens that it will not bend, that it will always fight for truth, no matter what the consequences, and that it will remain committed to finding the truth without fear or favor. Given such high ideals, it is a difficult challenge to sustain good journalism and also remain profitable. A section of the media has then taken recourse to entertainment in the name of news. Stories exposing great social and economic inequalities are ignored, and their place is taken by trivia. Instead of helping promote scientific temper, some run after irrational practices in their search for eyeballs and ratings. But I am confident that quality journalism will prevail in the long run, the kind of journalism we have gathered to celebrate today. I once again congratulate all the award winners and also their organizations that helped bring their work to light. I also congratulate the Express Group and the jury members for promoting excellence in journalism through these awards. I offer my best wishes to the young journalists whose work will be celebrated on this stage in the future. To them, and also to all other journalists, this advice from one of their greatest predecessors, Mahatma Gandhi, will serve as a good guide. I quote, "Always insist on truth and urge it with humility and grace. I am a journalist of long standing. In my own way, I claim to know my art well. I would therefore ask such of you as are journalists and publicists to curb your pen and tongue. Exercise the strictest economy of words, but not of truth. Restrain your expression, but not the inner light, which should burn brighter with increasing restraint." Unquote. I leave with you these words of the Father of the Nation. Thank you. Jai Hind.